Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another episode of People's Republic of China, here in Hearts of Iron 4. So, in the last episode, where did we leave off? Is the best question. Oh, right, that's where we left off. War started! We are now attacking NATO. Finally. So, the grand old fucking Japanese repelled our attack against them. We couldn't get to Nagasaki, and that's really sad. So we're gonna try a round two against them with more men this time. We have a tank here. Now we're gonna put with this guy. Oh yeah, I forgot we can't actually use him. But we did get the 50 divisions on there, so that's good. What else has happened? Warsaw is freaking huge. It's so big. So, NATO is going to have a really tough time. But the army's already getting ready over in Norway. I could send a bomber or two over to, like, Poland or, like, the Czechs. Try to, like, bomb England or something like that. There's a lot of planes going around here. That's another thing. Over in here, we have no really big ways of air superiority. It's really a bad thing. So we're going to go on 3-speed. Because, holy lord, there's a gigantic war going. Are we going again? We're attacking again. Are we really? I didn't even set the notion to attack. Why are you going again? Okay, go again then. Hopefully we'll win this time. We have a lot of troops. But not a lot of places to put those troops. We should probably, like, I'm guessing we could justify a war really quickly for you. No, it's actually going to take a long-ass time. We're going to do that. We're going to go ahead and get, Mao ready with his 85 troops along that border. Just to go and attack them, and then we'll attack Thailand, and then we'll go around over here. The British have a gigantic navy. Now, granted, we have a pretty decent-sized navy ourselves, but we've been building, like, not really that big of ships. So, what do we need to build? Strategic bombers. We don't have any strategic bombers right now. That's not good. Let's trade a little bit more with Republican Spain. What is this? Whoa, pause. What is happening here? Ask for military access. Who are you? Layout? Yeah. Because you guys are allied to me. Saraland, I think that's... Is that you? Which one are you? Who are you? Sure, even though you look democratic. And then Afghanistan wants to send me men. I don't want them. And Mongolia wants to send me men as well. I don't need them. We need more steel, but didn't we just trade for that? We're still trading with Germany. Let's go ahead and trade some more with Germany. We're doing a lot at sea. Hunt and destroy. You're going to give us a little bit more close air support. Let's continue. We do have a lot more planes, but the problem is we can't really use them. So I really don't know what to do. North Koreans are with us, which is very good. The Soviets and everything, they're kind of getting prepared. It looks like they're getting ready to start navally invading places, which is a very great thing. Sorry, that was a gigantic lag spike. So there's probably going to be some lag, just because it's huge over here. Are they pushing into Norway yet? Not yet. They have not decided to attack, and they don't. I think it's because of the frickin' desertion. You have so many troops over here. They're a lot stronger than you. Just because of the fact that you have so many. Like, look at all those troops that you have in one center. God dang. They're attacking over here, though. They're completely obliterating. There's the word. They're obliterating the Italians, which is very good. If they can continue that, it's going to be amazing. How much longer until the coup? Over halfway, so that's good. It's very good. We have 3 nukes, but we can't use them. It looks like we're trying to attack here and getting obliterated again. I need to drop these trucks and tanks from the battlefield, because we're not going to be able to bust through these Japanese. I think what we're going to do is we're going to cut that plan, and we're going to make a new invasion over, like, I don't know, like, here. Because if we do that, like, okay, you only have 38 divisions in there. That's fine. Luxembourg capitulated, which, of course, that was a fucking given. They're so small. It doesn't even matter. The French are eating up Belgium right now very quickly, very easily. Sorry if you can hear my phone in the background. Jesus, that's annoying. And I think they're going into the Netherlands now, too. Yeah, they're not even stopping. They're just going to go straight in. So the French are eating up a shit ton of land, and that's beautiful. The Soviets... Ooh, and the French are actually trying to attack Italy now. Winning on a few fronts, losing on a few fronts. So they really got to... If they can beat back these mountains, they can really do some stuff there. They got a lot of troops over here. Oh, I think they're getting ready for landing parties in Italy. Nice. And I haven't even set up the freaking coup yet. So it's not going to be a lot of us. What? Cambodia, sure. If we're not at war, then yeah, I don't need the expeditionary forces from North Korea. They can kind of just do what they want. How is air superiority? Do we have it? No, we need more planes. Like, we need a lot. We need a lot more. That actually gives us something to build. We need a new airbase. A big one. We need airbases straight along this sector. Because if we can get good airbases right here, we can nuke Japan very soon. So that's what we're going to do. We're gonna set up our dudes. It's going to be one of the first things that happen. No more nuclear reactors. We got to build these fucking airbases. Quickly. Quickly, quickly, quickly. But yeah, we're going to stop. Japan tried to charge our ships. That was really stupid of them. The Americans are still plopping troops here, but they aren't actually trying to attack me yet, which is very good. But I can't attack them. They'll obliterate me. So that is perfectly fine. The Vietnamese are not in the war, I don't think. Are they in the war? Vietnamese. They are. They're just not doing anything. Which is fine. But it's good that we actually have a war now. Good lord. Is that Greek? Those are some Greek men. What are they doing all the way over here? That's pretty funny. So, how long is it going to take? Where is he? Oh my god. There's no troops set to that. That's really annoying. There we go. Put those guys on there too. 32 divisions. I actually want to, like, not have you in the fight. If we're going to go, we're going to go with straight infantry. I think straight infantry is the way to go. Can we unassign that guy from that job? I don't think we can. Yeah, like, you have a job, right? Don't do that. Nah, I don't think. We would have to go individually and find every single one of those planes, so that's going to be really annoying. Somebody just messaged me on Skype. I don't know who that was. I will check that after the recording is done, because I do not care at the moment. Oh my god. Ooh, look at the French pushing into Italy. I love it. So they're fighting back past these mountains, which is really good, because then, there's all these guys, a gateway into Rome and stuff. But it looks like Canada is coming up with some troops. I think that's Canada. It's Canada. Yeah, it's definitely Canada. There's no way that's not Canada. Good god, there's a lot of lag just because there's so many units. Any pushing? No, it doesn't look like any pushing into Norway. But it's because everybody's deserting. Like, down here you could probably push to Oslo, but you got so many units in Sweden, it's not even funny. The French are kind of stuck. They're not even... What are they doing? They have so many troops, they could just bulldoze through, but they're not doing anything. Also, if I sound a little weird... It's because I'm a little bit under the weather again. Lots of sneezing happening. Surprisingly enough, none of these Soviet/Frenchmen are moving into... what's it called? Africa. Which I'm very surprised about. Egypt, how close are you to be actually becoming... Oh, you're at like 50%. You're about to be there. Oh, wow. They're encircling Italy on all sides. Which is actually going to be really good if Italy gets knocked out. quickly and easily, because that's one of the biggest guys out of here. The biggest one we have to attack in order to win is America, which that's going to be fucking difficult to do. We could go through Alaska and push down through Canada, but I really don't think that's going to be very smart. I mean, if we're going to do that, we have to get Anchorage to start. We have to, because they have the port, which is going to give us more supplies. And we have to attack basically all of Alaska, and we have to push through Canada with relative ease. But the U.S. has so many units, even putting like 50 units down there is going to be really difficult. A lot of naval battles between us, the British, Australians, and shit like that. We could go after the Philippines. They're not actually a part of NATO. And they're not puppeted by anybody. But I would rather go for like Australia or something. I just gotta make sure that my mainland isn't getting invaded, which it's not, but they're putting a lot of troops in here, which is really fucking annoying. They're trying their hardest to get something going over here in China, but I'm not gonna let them. 30 out of 108 days, we need to know the East China Sea and the Sea of Japan. We know the Yellow Sea, but we don't know the East China Sea, which is fine. We can just send these 132 ships, and we'll just go ahead and plop a commander down there, because that's a fucking gigantic army. The East China Sea and the Sea of Japan we need to know about, so we'll just plop all of those guys down. And I'm guessing not a lot of people are going to try to destroy us. Unless these guys are docking in. I think those guys, yeah, those guys are dipping out, so that's actually good. Because they're starting to get, they're going to start getting desertion here soon, and some UK men are starting to dip out too. So that's good. We'll just wait until they're really hurt. Or, like, really, what is it called? Weak. There's the word I was looking for. I could actually... Here's what I'm going to do. Which army is this? I'm guessing that's you? Yeah. We're actually going to send these 75 units into Europe. Or at least as close into Europe as we can. Let's, where's a good place where they don't have a shit ton of troops? I mean, Denmark needs to get invaded, but we can't. These are 75 units. I'd rather just not send them, to be honest with you, because there's so many. I don't want desertion to happen to the ranks. We should go into Africa. But, the French and all of them are already taking care of Africa, so why do that? Is that the Belgian capital? Oh, yeah, because they lost Belgium. Duh. Surprisingly enough, they haven't attacked. Like, there's so many units here. Go. Charge. Do something. They're trying to push into Italy, which is doing very well. They're about to get to Rome if they really fight hard enough. The Italians are really dying. Just fantastic. Nothing's really happening over here. Sorry about that lag. Ew. Basically, I'm just waiting to attack... Japan again. I need more fucking... Ah! We don't like 300 more, but I'd rather just wait until they're done. Like, until the whole thing is complete, and then know how much I need. Like, how close are we to getting those airports? We're at 7, 0, and 2. So we actually have an airport over here. Right there. Jesus, that's so far away, though. This is the closest one we got. We own a piece of land that belongs to North Korea. Why? I didn't know that. Why do we own that? That's weird. I want to nuke Tokyo so bad. I really want to nuke Tokyo so bad. I mean, because we have planes. It's just they have apparently more planes than us. Ooh, the Soviets are going on the top. Smart fucking idea, Soviets. Good job. I'm proud of you. Okay, so that is why we need to hurry up. Because what they're going to do, what the Japs are probably going to do, is they're going to send a lot of their men up north. Because of the fact that the Soviets are winning over here really easily, we're going to come down south. And we're going to try to pincer them. That's actually a really smart idea. Go, Soviets. I'm so proud of you. Jesus! Soviets got a lot of fucking ships. Good lord. This is the big prize, though. That's that big prize. We're gonna nuke the fuck out of America. And I'm American. Whoops. You're so close to Rome. Just go. Just go. Just charge. You can do it. I believe in you. You got it. Let nothing stand in your way, man. You're gonna kill it right now. Why aren't you guys attacking? Like, it looks like you guys are attacking, but you guys are just shifting through your lines. Attack. Do something. Oh, so close to switching. We're gonna get a lot of communism brewing here soon. How close are we to that freaking coup? Close. Very close. Very close. Good. Good. The Soviet bear is starting in the north of Japan. We're going to start in the south. Okay. I think we're doing very, very well. I'm just terrified. I'm just really scared. So they're... We can't really put... they're trying to continuously attack us here. It's not going too hot for them, and they're just losing lives. Oh my god, this is beautiful, though. Communism's gonna reign supreme over literally all the world. It's gonna be so beautiful once it happens. Ugh. And France is growing like a mother. Like, France is probably gonna get all of Italy, guaranteed. The Americans are sending troops, it looks like. Yep. They're sending troops around. I wonder where. If they're sending them over here, that's not going to be nice. Oh, the Americans dipped completely out of here. Oh my god, go. I want to see if we can win there. Now that the Americans dipped out. Hopefully we can. Are we going to win? Spain's going to take another 15 days, 16 days, 17 days, 18 days. Yeah, we're starting to lose now. Looks like. Yeah, okay. The general just doesn't think that we're going to be able to win. Now, granted, if I move some of these troops out, like, who's purple here? You? Yeah, get all your troops, dip the fuck out, like, leave. Just completely go. Like, I'll delete your freaking, your little sitting. Send that to you. Yeah, just get out. Just go. Leave. Who are you? Those are the Iranians. Hello, how are you? Oh, so close. It's just so close. Come on. I need you to do what you need to do. They stopped that attack over there? Why? You were winning. You were about to win. So basically, for us, it's going to be a little bit until expansion can happen. It's definitely going to be, we need to get air superiority. We are building up our airports, fucking finally. It's taken so long, but we're doing those. We're at 9 now. How much in this airport can we hold? 1,800. So I can hold about maybe close to, what, like maybe 600 airplanes? I just don't have the amount. Like, I have jet fighter 2s and stuff. Let's throw some jet fighter 2s, and then let's throw... Not World War II fighters. Fuck that. We'll throw some more jet fighters in there. Any more jet fighters that I can actually throw in? No. So let's go ahead and deploy all of those. That'll be very good. Ugh. We still need to start building an airport here. We haven't done that yet. So once those guys get in there, we're gonna send them to do air superiority over here in Japan. Because if we can nuke Japan, oh my god, is that gonna be so good. The Japanese are really shooting down our fucking planes. Damn Japs. It's fine though. We'll win. I believe in us. We're still deploying. When are you guys gonna be deployed? The 31st of October. Oh, that's actually very close. So let's just boost the day. And it's the 17th hour that they'll be deployed. Come on. There we go. So they're deployed now. Why does it say they're World War II fighters? Why did I click that? Why are they World War II fighters? They were jet fighters. That doesn't make any sense. They're jet fighter 2s. Why can't I use them? What? Heavy fighters can get there, but jet fighters can't?
Well, that doesn't make any sense.
That's actually fine, though, because we can fly them over here. Help out with the Soviets' northern part? Could probably do that. Well, actually, we could probably use that to get over here. Yeah, that makes some sense. So we got a new strategic bomber, and we need to start building that, apparently. We haven't been doing that. So let's go ahead and just max that out. Get the supplies that we need. Mexico. And then let's get the checks. Or the poles. Whoops. Wrong country. Which one do we need? Aluminum. Jesus. You don't have enough. Venezuela has enough. Okay. Aluminum 51. Let's just get that much from them. That should fix our issue, right? Oh my god. Come on. There we go, finally, Jesus. Alright, let's start researching the last one. Our strategic bombers. Are they deployed? They are, they're standing by. Can we use them here? No, we cannot. It's just out of range. Oh, that's so annoying. It's very annoying. We could put more planes in there, though. Only like 600. Inject close air support once, 48 of them. No, I want these head fighters, though. What is that? Let's move about. I wish I could actually put up how much, like, I don't know. I'm gonna throw up maybe about like 100 in there. Come on. Boom. If there's a more simple way to do that, please, for the love of God, tell me. So that way I can do that. It's really annoying. We can throw about 1,000 in there. Jesus, we've got a lot of planes. We just don't know what to do with them. Yeah, jet heavy fighters too. Why not? Why haven't we deployed those? Jesus. Once we get this air problem figured out at least a little bit, we'll go ahead and do that. What's happening in the rest of the world? Kind of a stalemate over in Italy. Haven't really done much. But I guess that's fine. We'll go ahead and do undersea blockades. And some carrier rolls. Still haven't taken Rome yet, which is going to be the big one against Italy. I'm guessing no attacking in Norway? Doesn't look like it. Could have been a little bit on their side, on the NATO side. But I don't think so. A lot of Americans over in Belgium right now. Which is fine, as of right now. Slowly but surely taking over Africa. And then we are lining up against Myanmar, which... not even a quarter. I think we're about a quarter of the way done with that. And then the coup over in the United States. Very close. Very close to being done. It's very good. Are planes deployed? They are. Jet fighters, go. Interception. What is that? Air superiority and interception. Yes, go do that, please. For the love of Christ. You're all on the home island. Okay. Still not. Goodness. Still no air superiority in the area. My god. Now we do have No, I want you, sir. Good lord, what is happening? Can you do that? I'm gonna be really pissed off. No, you can't. So shut your mouth. Don't show me that you can and then you can't. That angers me. Get out of my face. Now, if we look, we're almost halfway. Almost halfway. We just need more planes. God. They just have a lot of air wings. But we're building up some more. Hopefully, soon enough, we can get some more planes going. Now, granted, I could have like 700 planes if I were here and were just clicking the entire time. But that's still really annoying. Don't want to do that. 90 of 108 days. I'm going to go ahead and stop the episode here, though. In the next episode, round 2 against Japan, we're going to try again to attack the Japanese on a different landing. Now, we're going to land, hopefully, we're going to land right here. And then we're going to sprint over to Hiroshima very quickly to get that port. That's what we're going to just do. We're just going to do that. France, been doing very well against Italy. No attacks in Norway except for a tiny little bit over there. But there's a shit ton of troops. So a gigantic army. Nothing's being done, though. We got some rockets. Look at that. We got some freaking rockets from Romania and Bulgaria. Wow. Look at that. Now, if we bring some strategic bombers over to, like, Francais over here, we could plop 1,200 out of 1,200. That means some French planes are here. Right? Yeah. There are some French planes, of course. I should be noticing that. What about over here? There has to be a lot. Yeah. There's a shit ton. Damn it. I was going to say, if the French really aren't using their airports as much as I would think, we could use those. 0 out of 1,400, but we're not able to use that. Which is fine by me. But yeah, that's going to end this episode. Hopefully in the next episode, we see a lot more attacking. We did see some with the French taking a lot of Italy. In the next episode, we will see the United States coup starting up, which is going to fuck them up, hopefully. And then, really, we don't even have to worry about the Italian one, but that's going to start up here soon. So, oh well. And then we're going to try to attack Japan, hopefully, in the next episode. If we can get a lot of air superiority over here, we can nuke them, which would be awesome. Now, I wonder, because we have some jets. I'll probably end up finding this out later. Throw all those jets, though. Yeah, but until then, I'll go ahead and see you guys in the next episode of the People's Republic of China. If you liked this video, of course, down below, give it a like, comment. I love to see all your comments. And of course, subscribe for more if you have not already done so. I don't know why you haven't subscribed already if you're loving this series so much, because I'm going to be doing a lot more Hearts of Iron. Don't worry. We're going to continue. It's going to be beautiful. We're going to do a lot of campaigns. It's going to be great. A lot of mods, maybe. Maybe we'll go back to World War II. Who knows? But until then, I'll see you in the next episode. Take care, everyone.